a lot of people are the guys who own their own trucks, they own their own trailers, but they don't want the hassle of being independent.
Fighting to maintain their independence. They've been hitting the roadways all morning long. They parked their trucks here, and you can see behind me they are sounding off in front of one of the entrances here. Hundreds have stopped working today at both the ports of Long Beach and Los Angeles. They've led hundreds of convoys clogging up the 710, the 110, also the 91 freeways all day, and those protests have been staged at different areas. These drivers are protesting outside one of the port entrances here in Long Beach. They pulled over their trucks and have been making a lot of noise.
You gotta pay yourself, you gotta do your maintenance, you gotta do everything. It's just like the word describes it, independent, you know. You got nobody to back you up, it's just you. You set your hours, you set the way. You know, you gotta take care of the ins and the outs, and that's it.
Man, what up? This is a whole different visual from any other angle I've ever, like, done YouTube or, you know, filmed on, you know what I mean? But back to the topic, man, to the topic of the video, to the title of the video, AB5 situation going on in California, man. A lot of people saw it coming. At the end of the day, everything has to deal with money. I mean, that's, everybody know that. Everything deals with money. The basic sum of the AB5 is, a lot of people don't know what the AB5 rule is, what the AB5 bill is in California. You can no longer lease on your vehicle to a company and work underneath that company as if you are an independent contractor. Let's say, for instance, this is my truck, solely my truck. It's my truck. I bought it off the lot yesterday. I bought the step that I got on the back, I bought it yesterday. My truck and trailer. I cannot take this truck and lease it underneath a company, somebody else's MC number, somebody else's DOT number, stick it on my door and work for them underneath them. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people are like, man, why the heck is this rule being in place? There's a lot of opinions out there. I watched a lot of videos on it. There's a lot of opinions out there. And I'm going to sum up everything that I've gathered. I'll also drop the videos that I watched in the description of this video so you guys can go get your own opinion about what's going on and kind of get caught up to speed what's going on in California. It comes from these big, big, big companies, big trucking companies. A lot of the rates have went down because of these bigger companies. A lot of these big companies are trying to undercut each other all the time. For instance, perfect example, my dad always talks about TQL. Everybody knows TQL. If you're an owner operator, you know TQL. TQL is the type of company that will come in underneath another company, get the rate lower because a shipper, any shipper will want to pay less for shipping. I mean, that's just the goal. Everybody wants to pay less for shipping. I know I get excited when I order an Amazon package and they tell me I can pay less for shipping because I'm an Amazon Prime member. You feel what I'm saying? So everybody wants to pay less for shipping. TQL would come in, take that load or that contract and underbid it from somebody else. Let's say if you got a load paying $4,000 for 1,000 miles. TQL will come in and take that load for $3,000 for 1,000 miles. Now, I know you're saying it's a $1,000 difference. Check this out. When TQL comes and takes a load from somebody else, right? They're taking that load for $3,000, but they're gonna give you two. Let's say they're good guys. Let's say they give you $2,500. They give you $2,500 to go 1,000 miles. Now, you're making $2 a mile, $2.50 a mile, or $2 a mile, and TQL's made $1,000 or $500 off you. When before, that same load was getting, you were getting $4,000, and let's say, not you was getting $4,000, but the other guy was getting $4,000, and then brokering it out to somebody and giving them $3,000 or $3,500 for 1,000 miles, but you were making $3 a mile or $3.50 a mile for your load. But they were losing a lot of revenue in the load board, in picking up loads and dropping off loads department. So what they came up with was with the lease-to-own program. Now, I know a lot of people have heard about the lease-to-own program. I know I've heard about it. I thought it was a great thing before I even got into trucking with my dad. Basically, the lease-to-own program is you lease a truck from a company that will give you a truck. So let's say, for instance, I gave you this Peterbilt that I'm driving. I gave you this truck. But I say, hey, look, you have to pay a certain amount of money every single month for the next 5 years. And this truck is your truck. A lot of people hopped on the bandwagon or hopped onto that program because it sounds really good. So some of these lease programs will be like anywhere between, I've seen $3,000 a month to $4,000 or $5,000 a month. That's just to rent the truck. That's your truck payment. So of course you're paying for the truck, whatever how much the truck costs from the company, and then the company's making money on top of you for you trying to get to the lease to own program or whatever the heck, you know what I mean? A lot of guys were doing that. But you gotta think, they don't cover the same expenses they would cover if you were a company driver. Here we go. If you are a company driver, they're taking care of your fuel, they're taking care of anything that happens to the truck, maintenance, they're taking care of all that stuff. All you have to do is drive the truck. They pay you like an employee, a W-2. So you may be making anywhere between, some people make $800 a week, some people I make $2,200 a week. But with the lease on, you can essentially say all the money comes back to you, but you have to pay that money every single month. So you're making all the money, but you have to take care of everything too. So if your truck breaks down, I believe you got to take care of that. Now, of course, they offer things like, you know, roadside assistance and stuff like that, or even going to the actual shop so they take their trucks too, but you still have to come out of pocket. You may get a discounted rate on maintenance. You may get a discounted rate, but you still have to come out of pocket. You also have discounted with fuel, but you still have to pay for your own fuel. There's a lot of things that they found loopholes, because it sounds good to the person like me or you to be able to not pay certain fees or certain things that are obligated to pay for their employees. So back to what I was saying, 1099 versus a W-2. If you get a 1099, taxes are set up a lot different. You have to handle things by yourself, yada, yada, yada. It's a lot different than a W-2. W-2, they take taxes out. 1099, whatever you make, that's what you make. You're obligated to take care of those fees and those expenses yourself. So what California did was, they basically found out about this, or I wouldn't say found out. They started realizing that we're losing billions, not millions. We're losing billions of dollars because of this lease-to-own program. A lot of companies were doing it. And as well, to top on, you got to think, a lot of these guys who are lease-to-own, a lot of them go out of business. A lot of them bankrupt. You know, a lot of them have issues and stuff like that. The older guys will tell you, do not do it. A lot of the older guys will tell you, do not do a lease-to-own program. Some people still are doing lease-to-own programs and never have owned their own truck. So there's a lot of things that pros and cons that go into place. Now, some people, you know, you have a couple of people that, you know, paid off their truck, they did everything right, whatever. But a lot of people were in the courtrooms or going to court, taking these companies to, you know, putting them in lawsuits and different types of stuff like that. And they said that that was another reason why they wanted to implement this bill. I don't know how true that is, but they said that a lot of truck drivers were in court filing lawsuits against these companies because they were going bankrupt. California is losing a lot of money in the trucking industry because of that. Simple as that. Does it affect people like me? Well, I am an owner-operator, you can say, or you can say, a lot of people like to say, oh, you're a company driver for your family business. Either one. Either way, I wear the last name of my dad. This is our trucking company. We don't have anybody leased underneath us. Me and him are the only two drivers. That is all. We have 7 or 8 other trucks that we dispatch for. We basically have a fleet of 10 trucks. It does not affect us because we're not in that category. Now, a lot of people right now in America are scared, or not so much scared, but just worried that once California implements something, it usually transfers over. For instance, I've heard of New Jersey and Connecticut are trying to implement the bill already. They're already trying to implement, I think Indiana as well, and I think there was another state, I think it was Michigan or something like that, I can't remember. But they're trying to implement the bill into their thing now. So a lot of people are worried, like, man, if this is the case, a lot of people are going to go out of business. So there's a lot of protesting going on in California as well. A lot of these guys are owner-operators underneath these big companies. If you have Landstar, which is a huge company, and I don't know if it affects anybody in California with Landstar, but I just know Landstar is a huge company, and they do a lot of lease on. They have a lot of good discounts with their fuel, a lot of good discounts with their maintenance. But that's the same thing. It's the same process. So a lot of people are worried about, is this going to affect me? You know, I'm in such and such state, is it going to come over and it's going to affect me? Because getting an authority, this is another topic about it, getting authority is not as easy as it sounds. It's not as hard as it sounds either, though. It takes time, it takes patience, and it takes a little bit of money. You know what I mean? So it takes time to get to that level of owning your own authority. But with owning your own authority, I can see why a lease-to-own program is so beneficial for an owner-operator. You got to think. Yes, I have to take care of all my stuff still and pay this amount of money. But hold on, let me say this. If you don't have your own truck, but if you have your own truck, and you bring it to the table, and they're giving you all these benefits, all these discounts, yes, I can see why it's beneficial. If you own your truck, and you own your trailer, and that's where the hiccup comes with a lot of people, because a lot of people are not the guys doing the lease-to-own programs. A lot of people are the guys who own their own trucks, they own their own trailers, but they don't want the hassle of being independent. They don't want the hassle of going through an audit. They don't want the hassle of dealing with FMCSA all the time with audits and dealing with all that. They don't want the hassle of that. They don't want all that. They don't want the hassle of, you know, having to take care of things by themselves. It's cool knowing that you get a discount with fuel. It's cool knowing that you get a discount with maintenance. That's really freaking cool. It's cool knowing these things. It's cool knowing that you might get the best loads compared to everybody else who is independent. It's cool knowing that. So I can see how a lot of people are upset or enraged because they no longer have the opportunity to be leased on and get those benefits that they used to get. Now they have to be independent. Some people weren't ready to be independent. That's what the AB5 is, man. Definitely check it out. Check out the videos I left in the description. You know, comment, let's talk about it. That's it, man. AB5 bill, how y'all feel about it?
Hey, counting these commas, we run it up. All of these hoes, they won't come with us. Sipping that dirty, she getting real sloppy. Staying high, now she living the dreams. On her pants, Magello on me. Jolly Ranchers, mix it up with the lean. Johnny Dang, all my diamonds on fleek. Pop me a perk, cause she think I'm a geek. Hot in the land, why you looking at me? Counting this money, you ain't on my team. Setting a plot, we running through schemes. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, I want me a milli. I ain't gon' stop till I'm rich. Getting this money like Money Mitch. Promise again that I never switch. Yeah.